Morning, good morning to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. The topic given to me is the current scenario of waste management in the city and the BBMP's initiative for bulk waste generators. Before I go to the subject, I would like to just tell you briefly about the issues faced by the city and you know how the city is grappling with the problem of garbage. If you know, Bangalore city, unlike the other cities in the world, is a city which has developed over two decades. It grew very, very fast. Nobody could imagine the pace at which the city grew, and then the challenges also grew along with the issues of the city development. And the civic agencies did not have, suddenly they could not take this kind of onslaught of garbage management which came onto them. So then suddenly they were caught unaware, and then we started looking for various solutions. So finally now, last about 1.5 to 2 months, 2 years, 3 years, there has been a lot of initiative that's been taken by Bangalore City BBMP in making the city clean and getting the city clean and having a good garbage management system. Basically, what I have seen is where the city lacks in garbage management is we do not have effective control or administrative mechanism which is, it is not working at the optimal level, We need to have a good system of monitoring which is actually not happening. Second thing is, lack of civic sense among the citizens as well. So what is happening is, our people, though whatever efforts BBMP does, again, you see, we try to clear the whole garbage, next day we see that, people come and create the same problem again, we probably need to enlighten them, teach them. So what, there was an example which we did in Elahanka. Elahanka was a zone, I was a zonal commissioner of Elahanka. So we got the people together, we got the administrator together. We started having a solid dialogue with the RWS. When we started meeting them regularly on a regular basis, we picked up some 8 to 10 people from each ward, and then I started meeting them at least once in a month. So what happened then, this problem, what were the serious problems? Why were the garbage was not, getting cleared? Is the officer not responding? Or, is the garbage contractor cheating on, the number of vehicles to be given? Are the men actually who were supposed to come? Are they coming or not coming? So, what happened was, I started taking rounds in the morning at 6:30 in the morning. So, I used to personally go and check the mustering. So, I used to find there was a lack of, manpower, lack of, equipments. So, this is what happened. So, for example, there are 100 houses. Our boys used to cover about 60 houses. In 40 houses, what would they do? They would come and put the garbage. This was the problem. They said, "Just give us a solution. We will give it to you. We will not throw. We don't want to throw." So when we started talking to them, we started fine-tuning the system. Then Elahanka started doing 70% segregation. 70% segregation, and then most of the black spots. Now anybody, it's up to anybody to come and see those 11 wards. You can definitely see that. You will not see the major black spots what we used to see about 1 year back. So now a lot of them has been controlled. So basically, it is, I believe that when we have people RWA, people's participation in the system, then we have a good administration, good garbage management. So this has been an example which we have actually seen. Then afterwards, apart from that, each ward has got a separate challenge, and the solution also came from the people. When you talk to them regularly, they say this is the problem, so we need to address it this way. There was one lady, who took up the initiative and said, "Sir, I would keep these 4 roads clean. Just give me one person." And, she took the initiative. She did it on her own. You could go and see. You will not find any Singapore anywhere. It's so clean. Not even one leaf you will see. Then every 2 hours, the roads, all the 4 major roads are swept and kept absolutely clean. So these are the kind of initiatives which are really working. We started choosing people. The RWS were not somebody I would just pick up from this one. Somebody who has actually worked in the field, who has proven himself. So I have got a team of people in Elahanka who are my think tank. I have not done any wonders there. It is only that these people gave me ideas. I was an implementer. I just heard them. Okay, sir, I put them into action. Then we had to take our public places. If you take the Hebbal flyover, it was full of filth. We took our everybody's to take, bring the garbage just to throw it there. Our friend from Arun from Ugly Indians, you know, this is a group of people, and then Kamya from Jagat, they came over and said, sir, we would definitely like to do it. It was actually Arun's initiative. We took up the entire flyovers, he started painting them. Everything started, you know, completely the perception of the people changed. They started throwing garbage there. Second was, once we found somebody who was from outside, he came and stuck one post there. I found out immediately, yes, we caught him. We made him pay a fine of 20,000 rupees, an FIR was booked. I gave him a bucket and then asked him to clean the whole pillar. So when he did that, everybody was, you know, reported everywhere. So here what everybody got scared, you know, BBMP authorities will come behind us. They will catch us and make us do this. Next, another place, we saw him, another group of people littering on the Jakur Road. We somehow got the address, we caught him, we got his auto, he was dumping garbage there every day. We got him, we made him, made his whole family members come, take the sweep, sweep the road. I said, you should sweep the road. Otherwise, if you bring somebody else and sweep the road, it will not have any meaning. So we made that fellow sweep the road. He started sweeping the road and the whole thing got cleared and everybody got scared now. They don't dump in my lakes anymore. They don't dump in my roads anymore. They are very scared. My RWAs are very, very powerful. They immediately inform me. We have WhatsApp group for each ward where we have the RWAs officers, everybody interacting with each other. If somebody does not perform, if some black spot is not cleared or some civic issue is not addressed, it comes to my notice immediately and the concerned RWA talks to me. Automatically, before I could react, except my engineers or my RWA inspectors or whoever it is, if I have already attended to the issue. 70-80% of it is attended. Only when it is a very serious issue which needs my intervention, then only I intervene. Otherwise, it's functioning perfectly. It is there to see. Anybody could, get into that WhatsApp group and find out exactly what is happening. Most of our expert committee members are there, who are always our well-wishers and guides, who are always there. And most of our meetings are reviewed by our expert committee members who meet us on a very, very regular basis. And that's how we are able to face these challenges, control the problem of garbage. And second thing is that we have gone into a very, very clear, transparent micromanagement system of garbage, which is going to be actually planned for the entire Bangalore city. We have divided the each ward into 750 houses block. So one auto rickshaw goes to each house collecting wet and dry waste. In case they don't give them the segregated waste, he will not take it. He will ask them to segregate and hand it over to him. Otherwise, it is not picked up. So he goes around the 750 houses, collects it, comes back to us, and then he gives the garbage separately. And that we have a GPS system which monitors whether the auto actually has gone on that route or not gone. So people also will be aware exactly that whether the person that day has come or not come. So it is easier for my officers also to monitor. And then there is no reduction in auto. In case some block one auto doesn't come, then the garbage is not lifted. So that we have RWAs in each block. So they'll call up and tell us today the auto rickshaw has not gone. Please attend to this. So this kind of transparent system we have brought in. We are working on a similar model for Bangalore City. I know there are 198 wards. Elahka is just a small zone. It just has got 11 wards. So we are working. The challenges are more in Bangalore City. So we already have set the ball in motion. And then hopefully by maybe a month's time, we should be able to have this program. And it will be on the public domain. So everybody would know. And also, the auto rickshaw will be given a number like a route, bus route. So for example, ward number one, block A. So the auto will have block one and block A. So everybody will know this is my auto rickshaw. The driver's number is very prominently displayed. So in case they want to call him, whether to find out his location, they can find out. We are also going to put it on the public domain. So this is one level of micro planning for the city, which we are doing as regards the households. Now, second challenge is the bulk generators. The garbage comes from two sources. One source is places where BBMP is not able to lift from the households. And second thing is the bulk generators. Bulk generators, there are apartments like multi-dwelling units. Large apartments have good number of RWAs who are actually working for them. For example, I would like to make a reference of Godrej. We have about, in Godrej, there were 1,200 apartments. Then you have the Purva Venezia. All these apartments, not even a kg of waste comes out because they have in-situ arrangement there. There are some people who are really doing very good work. And they make their own compost, use it for their own gardens. And then we have absolutely no intervention. BBMP never intervenes in their work. So they are doing absolutely fantastic job of not getting the garbage onto the road. Similarly, we are also, these are very, very easy things to do. I don't understand because a lot of apartments, I was surprised to say that they used to just collect the garbage and, you know, come and dump it wherever they felt like. They used to have this, we have some empaneled bulk generators. They should, the people who are generating bulk garbage should take the facilities by the empaneled vendors, because we have given them certain rules and regulations from which they are supposed to follow. Like, for example, how they are supposed to collect the waste, where they are supposed to dispose it of, these kind of things. These are things which cannot be given to XYZ, you know, who can just take it and throw it wherever they feel like. This is what is happening in most of the cases. 30 to 40% of the garbage which comes from the bulk generators, comes straight away, it comes onto the streets, and then, you know, again, we have a problem, we have a huge black spot. For example, I would like to tell you, bulk generators, again, meat generation. We had a problem of meat generation in ward number 6 and 11, where there are a lot of slaughterhouses and, you know, meat. We made a program and systematic micro-planning there also, where outreach, I think Rajesh was speaker, Rajesh and Ajay, they have helped us do that. They go house to house, shop to shop. We make fixed up a fees, 200 rupees per week, you pay them, you know, he goes to his, each shop, picks up the meat waste and things like that. And then scientifically, we take advice of Arbitra Madam and Ramakan sir, and then we immediately, you know, dispose it off the way it is done, so that, you know, nobody, you know, has a problem. Last time, Bakrid also, we had a very serious issue, festival waste. Suddenly, Shivaji Nagar was full of waste and it was supposed to come onto the road. Then we discussed about that. Me and Ramakan sir had a preliminary meeting on how to handle this. Then immediately, we took the entire city, Yelahanka took the entire city's meat waste, and we handled it absolutely. There was no problem. Nobody even whimpered. So, similar kind of arrangements we did. And this also happened for Ganesha festival and also for Dashera, where a lot of garbage and then, you know, a lot of garbage used to come there. We also made station-wise, we had a micro plan for that also. Our RWs were there with us. Each point, wherever the garbage was being generated, we had a tractor in place so that no garbage goes onto the road. It directly goes into the tractor. And then it was brought into some farmers, you know, they were very kind enough to give us their land to compost it. So we straight away sent that this one to there, and we started composting there. Then even on the occasion of Ganesha festival, we requested them to bring in eco-friendly Ganesha. If you see, we have made a you know, complete records of the kind of Ganeshas which came in. Most of them, 16% of them got eco-friendly Ganeshas. And some of them who could not do it, some of them, they left it on the road and went away. But we as volunteers, our RWS did the honors, and then we dispose it off the way we had to do it, you know. We had made a separate for wet and wet collection there, wherever whatever flowers used to come used to be collected separately. Whatever items used to come after doing the honors, we used to put it in one place, so that otherwise, you know, the water holes used to stink. So completely, it was within 2 days we had the whole area clean. So again, this happened because of the help of the people. It was only the RWS, and it directed by observed the RWS, performed by the BBMP. So we were able to achieve good results, and that was also documented in most of the places. So similarly, we would like to do it for the city as a whole. So this kind of micro-level planning is what is required right now for the city. And second thing is, coming back to bulk generators, I also request that, you know, huge apartments are there. There are people who are abandoned. They also have facility to provide in-city arrangements. Like, for example, they will help you with some devices where you can compost your own garbage. There's no rocket science in that. They will give you the service, or they'll give you the product. You can take as a community. Anybody has got some 10 to 10, if it is a small multi-dwelling unit of 10 to 12 kitchens, then you have a small place at the bottom or at the top. You can definitely do it. Yelahanka is already doing it. Already, my people are converting. Dr. Sandhya is here. She's taken a lot of lead. Our MOH has taken a lot of lead in converting people to have in-situ arrangements so that that garbage doesn't come out. Now, people are realizing that, you know, plastic is valuable. Even the compost is valuable. And a lot of people are converted. Whenever I go, they say, today I see some, last week I had some 4 or 5 women who came, sir, I would like to take up. As an industry, I would like to do it. I said, very well, please take it up. As long as the garbage doesn't come in, if you are doing as per the MSW rules, you have absolutely nothing to say. It is between you and the bulk generator. We will be arbitrators for you in case you have any issues. So this kind of arrangements, until and unless our city goes into some kind of an in-situ arrangement or some kind of a bulk generator operating system, ultimately, it is our responsibility also to know that your bulk generator, what is it doing with their garbage? Is it going in, putting it in somebody else's ward? Is it going in, throwing it in some lake? That is what is happening. Most of the generators, you know, they have got apartments in the poor area where they are generating like 500, or 500 kgs, 1,000, 1 ton, half a ton. These kind of garbage comes into our periphery areas. We are feeling the wrath of that, you know. there are huge Raj Kalways, like, you know, we have the water bodies, they are coming and dumping. I think last year we find about 5 lakhs, 6 lakhs, 7 lakhs there. We seized the vehicles in the night. We came to know that they are dumping in the lake. We have a very strong body, the same RWS, they monitor our lakes as well. One small fish dying in the lake also is immediately brought to my notice that, you know, sir, there is some problem in the lake. Probably somebody has dumped something or something, and somebody let some sewage inside. So this is the kind of micro monitoring we do in the ward, in the zone. The similar kind of arrangements, we are working very hard, because I know the city has got a lot of challenges. We are working very hard to make this kind of transparent system come into BBMP, and, you know, make people also, you know, a big part of, you know, our, you know, what do you say, our, make them also our strength, and see that, you know, our city remains very clean. I had some delegations from other countries who came in. They could not believe that, you know, Bangalore city actually, you know, is segregating, the entire city is segregated 45% of its waste. Even a city like London doesn't segregate so much. I think it's 70 to 20%. The city, Bangalore city is 50%, and some blocks like HSR and things like that are doing 70%. Yelahanka zone itself does 70%. So when we can do it, it's not a very difficult, you know, task, a difficult dream for us, you know, to achieve this. So at, we are also thinking of bringing in a policy wherein any new building which comes up shall have a solid waste management, you know, system that they have to show us, which is a workable model. Without that, you know, the permissions will not be given. So this is going to be a policy decision. Until unless they don't have a system in place, again, you know, we'll have the garbage going into the system. It's high time. We need to have some you know, system in place. And also, it is BBMP is nothing but its people. As long as you don't participate and, you know, you don't you know, bring this to our notice, things will definitely, it is not possible by just the BBMP commissioner or the engineer or anybody to, you know, take things under control. So this is an example which has really worked in Bangalore, where people, RWS themselves have driven the administration. So we have shown an example of how the people-driven administration is more functional, more transparent than whether it is a bureaucratic, compared to the bureaucratic or an official administration. So always, it should be a good you know, mixture of people and bureaucrats which make the system work you know, in a perfect harmony and, you know, in a perfect way. So ultimately, before I conclude my you know, today's talk, I would like to again, I think a lot of bulk generators are here. We have a list of vendors with us. Dr. Sanjay is here, she can share the list of that. And also a lot of people who are giving you in situ, you know, arrangements, solutions. Our Dr. Makan sir is there, Almitra madam is here. They themselves have got a lot of solutions. You know, you can feel free to mail us, talk to us. We are always there as a friend, philosopher, and guide, or whatever, in whatever way. And we request you again not to you know, give your garbage to an unauthorized person, so that, you know, the garbage doesn't come onto the streets again. And then we are going to go very, very strictly behind them. And then already we have already done very serious action has been taken against this kind of people. Apart from finding them, we are going to put them behind bars. So this is going to be very, very serious. So please take this taken as an advice and also as a warning. And with this, I conclude. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for bringing to light the various practical issues faced by the BBMP and for reinforcing your efforts in a proactive way to intervene. And good to know about the overall results. Great to know that citizens are getting involved and having a positive effect as well. So the more we hear these stories, the more we all want to get involved as well. So I'll just open the floor quickly for two quick relevant questions. Yeah, please, ma'am, if you can speak up.
Two
questions are, you know, what do you say, pertinent, and also I would like to react to that. See, as regards, maybe you may contest on the figures, but the figures are, because as you know, we have got 7 plants here which are processing the garbage, wet separately, dry separately. These are figures. You can go to any of this, or you can take the information in RTI, what is the kind of garbage which is coming. We are not, BBMP will not say just because when the BBMP commissioner speaks here, he doesn't speak,
he,
you know,
himself has
absolutely.
60 tons.
No,
so he
that's
is part of a committee.
Absolutely.
The committee said only 60 tons is coming.
Once again, so these are you can just go through. I'm not talking about KCDC, I'm talking about the city. You can go through our plants, you can go through our website, you could see, expert committee members are here, the kind of mixed waste which is going. Yes, I understand. What you say is KCDC, yes, it is a little overloaded because now Bangalore city is involving technology now. We are in the process of, like, you know, there are about 40-50 companies from different parts of the world who have come in and shown their technology. Whatever you are talking, there is a technology which is higher than this. There are no, let me tell you, madam, because I have day in and day out, I start my day at 6:30, I end my day at 9:30. So I meet more than 20 people every day who come with some new technology from all over the world. And nobody has got any proven technology for your kind of information. They all have got technology to incinerate. Everybody is burning their garbage. That technology is there. But KCDC, yes, who's bringing in the tomato? Who's bringing in the vinegar? It's not me. It's not the BBMP. It is the people. They should understand. How much can my people segregate? We are doing, see, what has happened, I guess, every time I'm going, wet waste. They give you a wet waste, wet food. If they include vinegar and garlic, I can't sit and, you know, BBMP people cannot sit and garlic. Some amount of understanding, some amount of, you know, what do you say? That's what I said. Our people, administration, I'm not saying administration is 100% doing a good job. I'm not. They also need to be tweaked up. And what about the civic? See, people also should understand, the citizens also should understand, you know, what has to be done, what not has to be done. For example, we have about 11 biomethanization plants where we are already using it, which is supposed to get in 5 metric tons of garbage every day and supposed to give electricity to 1 street or 2 streets or 3 streets or whatever. And then they very strictly say, please do not put lemon, please do not put orange, because it kills the microbes. What are we going to see? Where are we going to start? So this is what it is. It is, that's what I said, it's a good mixture of, you know, people and administration. We have just started off, madam. A lot of technologies have come in. We are looking at it. We are evaluating it. None of the technologies for your kind information is proven. Nowhere. If I have to give, tomorrow I want to go, there's a company which has come from Denmark, they want to come in. I said, how many years are you doing this? They said, this technology is about 12 months old, 24 months old. You know, what about your burning? Yeah, we are burning, we are doing for a long time. So burning, I don't need anybody. I can burn my garbage here. I don't require anybody to come from Germany to burn my garbage. So we are trying, madam, so be a little patient, because as you said, you know, Singapore, it took 40 years. Okay, London, it took 100 years. We are just 20 years old, madam, and we have just opened our eyes now. And believe me, in your lifetime, definitely you'll see a green and nice color.
So can we have a second question?
No, I'll tell you about mechanical segregation, which has got a misconception.
So this mechanical segregation, madam, you are recommending. Here, in my rounds when I go, more than 50% of the people dispose of their wet waste with a Brahmagantu on top and put.
Yes, exactly.
Which mechanical segregator will take that out?
Exactly, that's what I'm telling you.
This mechanical segregators which comes. No, mechanical segregators which comes. You put diapers also in that, they put sanitary waste also in that, all even the medical strips, everything you put in there.
So
all that will be immediately taken by medical
strips.
Okay, in the interest of time, I think there are, obviously we have very passionate citizens, and it's great to have passion, because I think that shows that we are very, very concerned about the issue. And I think we need engaged and passionate citizens, and we need engaged debates. But in the interest of moving ahead and moving forward, may I take one or two more questions? Yes, yes please. No. That we can have offline. Any other questions? Yes. Yes, please.
I have one question.
Yes.
To drive in a Bangalore for 5 or 10 kilometers, why timeline to stop it, right? Yeah. We are actually, if you see, I think you can, if you are following Facebook, you can see that, you know, we have started transferring the points, what you say, they are called the transit points. We are going to transfer, because what is happening is, because of the constraint of space, you know, there, which actually is illegal, we're not supposed to do it. We are slowly, I think in another 6 months' time, we'll be able to remove all this transit point. Actually, we have started converting now. Winternal Road, we have done yesterday, you can go and have a look. And then we have done the ESI Road. Then we have the Tanisandra Main Road. Then we have done, you know, the Kogilu Road. So we are converting this slowly. So it will definitely, in maybe another 5 to 6 months' time, we'll not find any crash on the road. We are shifting the transit point
transfer station
stating.
For which space is required? It doesn't have space to
do it. Yes, madam, please tell. Absolutely, if you can suggest, I can help you set up. Absolutely, I have been talking to, I don't know, I have not spoken to you, I have been speaking to, because I am just 3 weeks old into this assignment, so I have just been meeting RWS now. So Shantinagar, there were a couple of people who I know had met me, so probably next week sometime I plan to come to Shantinagar and address the, I was planning to empower the RWS there, form groups and then, you know, give you this action plan so that, you know, you can monitor your garbage mechanism. See, this actually, we were a little skeptical when we started off this program because it was started by me in Elanka zone. It was actually, it is not my plan, it was basically the plan given in the local RWS, this is how it should be. And that plan has become successful and that's how we want it. We have already started finding people in Elanka who are not doing it. So we are going to have a Bangalore city, we are going to have a plan for the entire Bangalore city. That time, you know, you will come to know your block. So we'll make one or two RWS responsible there. So you will be immediately, you know, we'll start finding them. We are going to give a card to the residents. In case they don't give the card, it will be registered there, so it can be.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you can please restrict your questions to your corporate questions, because we are here not to discuss individual household issues. We are here to discuss corporate questions, tech campuses, companies, and how they should manage their waste. So if you have any questions for the Special Commissioner, I would really be glad, because we don't want to distract ourselves by asking questions which should be actually done offline.
Sir, with the recent plastic ban gazette that has come out, how is it going to be enforced in these large tech parks? Because they are using a lot of plastic, they are using a lot of disposable.
No, we actually have
some kind of enforcement that is going to happen.
No, I see. We have just started. We have just started a campaign now for I think. Ward level RWS are going along with our officers, actually, you know, enlightening people on the ban, and then we are seizing plastic, destroying this is, we don't burn it, we just cut it into pieces.
Is this seizing happening even in the tech parks?
Okay.
Not retailers, but we're talking
about... No, tech parks, of course, we're going to shortly call all of them. We're going to have a meeting with our expert committee members, and then we are definitely going to, you know, advise them, you know, what are the alternatives. We're going to suggest some alternatives also. They have to switch over, you know, there's no alternative to alternative to not using plastic.
I have one last question. I have a small suggestion.
Yeah.
Since you took up the initiative with Yelanda, you should conduct meeting on the regular cases and be very close to them. Why don't you have meetings
No, no, yeah, just quickly.
Once again, folks, this is actually meant for companies and tech campuses. Let's not distract ourselves by asking independent questions of what each individual household gets. So, may I request, do you have a question about your company or campus?
One of the vendors. I just want to say one thing as a technology provider, German company, I would like to say that all technologies have limitations. But a technology only becomes a solution with political will, bureaucratic will, and civic will. And for that, I really commend Mr. Sarfaraz Khan. And I think we need more government leaders like him. So I would only say, as a technology provider, I cannot solve Bangalore's problem without the government. I cannot solve the Bangalore's problem without Deepak, and I cannot solve Bangalore's problem with SARS. So I really thank you for your initiative, and I hope just we have not just 3 weeks, but 3 years and 30 years to look forward.
I think we'll close the question and answer session. SARS is available at T, so anyone with any more questions can approach him directly. A small memento before Sir leaves, and I just want to inform you about some stalls being put up outside. We have a stall on Swachhagraha, so.